Greetings all, welcome to my video. From the eventchronicle.com. Forbidden History. UFOs in Ancient Art. By UFO International Project. UFOs have been a long-standing tradition in civilization's history. You may have seen some of this evidence by now: cave paintings, stone carvings on pyramids, and old medieval paintings, all of which have some interesting resemblances to modern descriptions, and pictures of modern aliens, and UFOs. If you read some ancient Vedic writings, it talks about vimanas, a type of chariot or palace, that the gods used to fly around the universe, at great rates of speed. Many of the descriptions and pictures of vimanas look very much like UFOs, especially flying saucers some people now talk about. Mayan alien. This stone relief engraving from the ancient Mayan culture shows a man bowing to something. We're not sure what he's worshipping, but we probably suspect that it might be the being above him, hovering over him in spaceship-like object. The object is lenticular, meaning it looks like a lens almost, and there are tentacles, exhaust fumes, or organic material such as creepers, dangling from the bottom of the vehicle. The being inside the craft appears to be angry, and his eyes are large, and almond-shaped, similar to the common facial descriptions of a gray alien. He's also wearing a type of vest, with two belts forming an X, on his chest. Some people believe this stone engraving may be depicting the Mayan god Quetzalcoatl, but it might also be depicting a type of alien. Or are they the same? It is believed by some researchers that the ancients revered the beings from the stars, and sometimes worshipped them as gods descending to Earth. Egyptian flying saucer. This interesting set of hieroglyphs depicts a radiating disc object, which, again, might represent the sun. This time, however, we see a capsule-like object, with a being inside it, contained within the radiating light. The being appears to have a flattened head, and shortened stature, similar in appearance to the one Elliot meets in Steven Spielberg's movie, E.T. The object itself looks similar to many UFOs drawn and photographed, but its dome is more concave-looking than the hat-shaped UFOs we saw before in all the Christian paintings. While this all doesn't prove that ETs created the pyramids, this hieroglyph does suggest there was some belief in flying spaceships during the ancient Egyptian times. Since the figure doesn't look human, we can also suppose that the Egyptians believed in some sort of beings from outer space who weren't human. This hieroglyph is found in the Dendera temple in Egypt. The ancient king. By some accounts of avant-garde theorists about Egypt, aliens may have been responsible for building the pyramids of Giza, one of the world's seven wonders. It is interesting to discover that modern builders are baffled as to how the pyramids were built. A modern skyscraper builder has stated that we do not currently have the technology and means to make the pyramids the way they did, so for many, it begs the question of some outside intervention other than humans. At any rate, there are some interesting images of what appears to be some sort of UFOs inscribed on the pyramid's walls. Take this example in the photo above. A sphere radiating some sort of luminescence is radiating light on the hands of some royal entourage of Egypt. The group appear to be holding their hands up in compliance to the sphere, which appears to have a godlike presence in the representation. We might speculate that the sphere is the sun, or some godlike energy descending to Earth. Or we could speculate the orb is some sort of UFO. Asia's UFOs. This photograph is from an ancient text from the East, called the Prajnaparamita. In it, we can see a type of guru figure, enthroned in front of a number of disciples or friends. There are some fires lit in front of them, and there are a number of racks set up with food or water. To the right, however, are some, by now familiar, shapes in Western painting, two hat-shaped objects, hovering mid-air, between the two figures squatting in front of the fire. Reports of the flying vehicles are also present in the well-known text, the Ramayana, in which it says Lord Rama, as well as his mortal foe Ravana, sometimes traveled long distances in a flying machine. There are also many texts in India, still untranslated, that speak of a flying ship resembling flying saucers. These are called vimanas and are thought to be flying palaces or chariots. British UFO. This drawing was done after a UFO sighting in 1783, outside Windsor Castle in England. Four witnesses to the event claimed they all saw a sphere, contained inside a cloud, move across the horizon at 9:45 p.m. at night. Pale blue in color, the object came to a halt in the sky, and then became brighter, as it continued moving off to the east, where it changed direction, witnesses said. It was last seen in the southeast direction from the castle. The light it emitted was prodigious, according to the witnesses, and lit up everything on the ground beneath it, before vanishing. The sighting was recorded the following year, in the Philosophical Transactions of the Royal Society. The event was witnessed by Thomas Sandby, founder of the Royal Society. The baptism, dating 1710, and created by Flemish painter, Aert de Gelder, the painting is titled, The Baptism of Christ, giving Gelder's rendition of what befell there on that day, when Christians believe Jesus received his first baptism, with John the Baptist. The light coming from above, typically viewed as the Holy Spirit, present at the ceremony, is painted as a flying disc. Was Gelder some sort of UFO believer, who thought that God manifested through a variety of flying saucers, that the Middle Ages people, may have sometimes seen flying across the skies? Painters like Da Vinci, were notoriously quiet on the meanings of their works, leaving many puzzled about what they meant, centuries later. But seeing this makes one wonder, whether Gelder and others had UFO encounters. The glowing wheels. This painting shows an actual representation of a UFO sighting report in 1697. The sighting was allegedly comprised of two glowing wheels that hovered over the skies in Hamburg, Germany that year. In the rendering, which doesn't seem as masterful and professional as the previous paintings we saw, we see two spheres suspended in the air over Germany. Underneath them are a mountain range, and a bunch of people staring up, and pointing at the sight, in the skies overhead. The spheres appear to be emanating some sort of smoke or light, radiating out from their edges, and notice how the objects appear to be gigantic in size, relative to the people below. Since nothing human was flying back then, these cases become tougher to explain. Mary's Ascension. This black and white painting shows Mary ascending into the clouds, near to the end of her term on earth, after bearing what many Christians believe was the Son of God. Interestingly, we see some unusual clouds around her ascension into heaven that look suspiciously like flying discs, particularly the ones of lenticular shape we sometimes see on photographs and TV shows. Below Mary, a group of disciples are gathered, apparently in fear about the miraculous event they are witnessing. On each of Mary's sides, are angels with trumpets, which might distinguish the UFO-like shapes from angels perhaps. In total, there are over a dozen shapes that look like UFOs in this image. The painting was done by an artist named Anon, in the year 1490. Moses UFOs. In this painting, we see Moses receiving the Ten Commandments from the sky, but we wonder whether the artist is really saying here that the prophet got them from UFOs. Or perhaps he or she is saying that God travels in UFOs. There are different possibilities for interpretation, but the fact remains that there are some unusual objects in the sky in this artist rendering that look very similar to UFO photos, off in the distance. In the painting in wood, we can see four or so dots that appear to be flying vehicles. The painting, whose artist and date is unknown, is currently hanging in Conti d'Utremond, in Belgium. An interesting thing about these paintings is that Moses appears to have a light shooting up from his head, some sort of holy light. The objects in the sky also have the same color of light shooting upward, indicating a connection. Mary's UFO blessing. Completed in 1486, this painting appears to show a UFO in the sky off in the distance. In it, we can see a circular or donut-shaped object, emanating a golden laser beam from the sky, into an aperture in a building. The light passes into the building, striking the head of a woman, as if in a sort of blessing. The scene again depicts Mary, holding an infant in her arms, presumably the Christ child. The painting appears to clearly indicate the presence of a flying saucer in the sky. The painting, called The Annunciation with Saint Emmidius, hangs in the National Gallery in London. This painting, and others, certainly make one wonder whether there were groups considered heretical who were putting forward that UFOs were involved with Jesus' birth and life. Maybe they were doing this in a slightly mysterious way to avoid persecution, or perhaps they thought the UFOs were some sort of angels, sent from God, who must have been present at Jesus' time. Jesus UFOs. This painting, titled The Miracle of Snow, shows Jesus with a woman next to him, maybe Mary Magdalene, in heaven, looking down on an assembly of medieval period people below. Above the people's heads, are regular formations of lenticular clouds, that may represent the snow mentioned in the title. But are these clouds really depicting snow? Actually, these shapes look eerily similar to the shapes of some UFOs, that many people say they encounter. It makes one wonder, was there perhaps a group, which was trying to make these shapes look like clouds, but really trying to get the message out there, that there was a link between UFOs and Jesus? This whole idea almost sounds familiar. You may remember the Da Vinci Code, and how Dan Brown theorized that there was a secret group of artists and thinkers in the Renaissance period who believed they were descended from the bloodline of Jesus and Mary Magdalene. If Mary Magdalene is present in this painting, then it may point to a connection between this UFO believer group and this secret bloodline group, known as the Priory of Zion. Mary's UFO. This tapestry is entitled The Magnificent. Mary is garbed in a more royal costume, a purple robe, and we can see a red halo hovering over the top of her head. She is meeting someone who appears to be a queen or a royal person of some sort. It could also be a wise man or magi again, but it's unclear from the details we have. In the background again, we can also see a hat-shaped flying saucer off in a field nearby. This time, it's tilted up on its side, as if moving down at angle, or hovering in the air at a steep angle. This tapestry hangs in bone, burgundy, and was made around the 1300s. Another Mary's UFO. This tapestry, created in the 14th century, depicts the life of Mary, mother of Jesus. The two on the right of the image on the tapestry, appear to be two of the wise men, or magi, who visited Jesus in his infancy, in Bethlehem. With a humble cloth around her head, Mary is on the left, staring sort of sadly, or dejectedly at the ground. Just above her head, near some mansion-like buildings, is a picture of a flying saucer, or at least, it appears to be so at first glance. The tapestry hangs today at the French Basilica of Notre Dame, in bone, burgundy, right next to the one depicted in the previous tapestry. It was designed and painted in 1330. An immediate guess is that the hat-shaped object appearing in the background was probably not intended to be some sort of flying hat. The flying pods. Entitled The Crucifixion, this painting, created in 1350, is located above the altar in the Vysoki Dečani Monastery in Kosovo, Yugoslavia. It appears to depict two humanoid-like persons, or beings, moving among the stars in an orb-like object, similar to some reports of acorn-like UFOs, sometimes in the skies today. Since the painting seems to relate to Jesus' passion, we might wonder how the images here connect to that event. It seems likely that they might be something similar to the Star of Bethlehem, which was reported to be seen in the skies during Jesus' birth in Bethlehem. Madonna's UFO. This 15th century painting, which was most likely done by Domenico Ghirlandaio, hangs in Lesser, in Palazzo Vecchio, in Italy. While apparently just an ordinary sort of painting of a woman from the Middle Ages, you might notice in the background a strange object, almost saucer-like in appearance, hovering in the blue skies beyond. Off in the distance, to the right of the woman, a man and a dog are standing near a cliff, gazing up at the object in the sky. Since the painting is called Madonna with Saint Giovanna, we can assume the Madonna in the photo is the woman, while the man standing beyond, is the saint mentioned in the title. Was the painter saying that some of the saints he knew of at the time, were in some sort of rapport with the flying saucers? It seems like one possible theme of the painting. At least, it shows us that flying discs weren't an invention of 1950s imagination. UIP summary. These are just a few examples of ancient art depicting UFOs and aliens. There are many more out there, widely available to the public, but how many more have been destroyed, or even hidden by the elite? Or shall I say, the religious elite like the Vatican? I am pretty certain that the Vatican's vaults are full with evidence of the alien presence, for how long will they keep the truth hidden to the public? I guess as long as they control the people, with fear using religions. This article, UFOs in Ancient Art, was originally published on UFO International Project, and syndicated by the Event Chronicle. Now enjoy these bonus paintings I've dug up. Vimana, India. A Vimana is a word with several meanings, ranging from temple, or palace, to mythological flying machines, described in Sanskrit epics. References to these flying machines are commonplace in ancient Indian texts, even describing their use in warfare. As well as being able to fly within Earth's atmosphere, Vimanas were also said to be able to travel into space, and travel underwater. Descriptions in the Vedas, and later Indian literature detail Vimanas of various shapes and sizes. UFO radio. Painted around 1600 AD by the artist Ventura Salim Beni, the glorification of the Eucharist, or exaltation of the Eucharisti, has in recent years become known as the Sputnik of Montalcino. This is because, at first glance, it would appear to depict the world's first artificial satellite, Sputnik 1. The content of the painting, originally commissioned by the Church of San Pietro, in Montalcino, likely has a less esoteric explanation. The object in question is actually a celestial sphere. However, not everyone agrees with this analysis, and some think a mystery lies at the heart of these peculiar objects, found in paintings throughout history. South American UFO pilot. The sarcophagus of King Kayanich Janab Pakal, or more commonly known as King Pakal, is one of the most talked about subjects when it comes to the ancient alien theory. The sarcophagus lid of this great Maya ruler has some pretty curious depictions. Ancient alien theorists propose that it clearly depicts King Pakal in some sort of spaceship during takeoff, and they argue that his hands appear to be manipulating some sort of machinery, his foot is located on a pedal, while he is inhaling through some sort of breathing apparatus. These images from the 12th century manuscript, Annals Lauris Sensis, Latin for volumes or books about historical and religious events, depicts the Saxon siege of Sigeberg Castle, France, in the year 776. The Crusaders had the medieval French completely surrounded, when the flaming shields suddenly appeared in the sky. The manuscript reports this as being over a church. Assuming the French were being protected, the Saxons fled in fear from the UFOs. Image from the French book, Le Livre des Bons Moeurs, The Book of the Moralities, by Jacques Legrand, 1338. The sphere resembles a Montgolfier, hot air balloon, but there were no balloons in 14th century France. Notice also, several daylight stars, the monstrous faces in the rocks, and the men are offering seeds. 17th century fresco of the Crucifixion, Svetishovly Cathedral, in Mtskheta, Georgia. Note the two saucer-shaped craft on either side of Christ. In the two blow-ups, you can see that they contain faces. Certainly ancient UFOs were associated with the highest of divinity, but were the requisite lights also thought to be the eyes of angels? If you zoom in closely to this painting named La Tebaid, by Paolo Uccello, you can see a strange UFO flying saucer-type object. Under the cross, sort of flying by. This painting was done sometime in the early 1460s, and is currently hanging at the Academy of Florence. A beautiful piece of art, named Summer's Triumph, from 1538, in the Bayerisches National Museum. If you look at the top left corner, you can see what could be described as flying saucers, or UFOs. Unfortunately, many people believe these are just clouds, but many artists hide and deceive what they are trying to portray, and this could easily have been a case similar to that, where the artist was showing a pair of UFOs. A broadsheet news article printed in April 1561 describes a mass sighting of UFOs. The broadsheet, illustrated with a woodcut engraving and text by Hans Glaser, measures 26.2 centimeters, 10.3 inches, by 38.0 centimeters, 15.0 inches. The document is archived in the prints and drawings collection at the Zentralbibliothek Zurich, in Zurich, Switzerland. According to the broadsheet, around dawn on April 14, 1561, residents of Nuremberg saw what they described as an aerial battle, followed by the appearance of a large black triangular object, and then a large crash outside of the city. The broadsheet claims that witnesses observed hundreds of spheres, cylinders, and other odd-shaped objects that moved erratically overhead. The broadsheet describes objects of various shapes, including crosses, globes, two lunar crescents, a black sphere, and tubular objects, from which several smaller, round objects emerged and darted around the sky at dawn. Thank you for watching. Please help spread the word and make a difference by sharing and subscribing for more thought-provoking content, and give us a thumbs up if you liked the video. Your support is greatly appreciated. Be aware and stay safe. We'll be right back.